Ab ipso, benedicatur hoc incensum inquis in requiemitur, nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, amen. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and the great commandment. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Gloria in excelsis Deo. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who hast given unto us thy servant's grace by the confession of a true faith, to acknowledge the glorious and eternal Trinity, and in the power of the divine majesty to worship the unity. We beseech thee that thou wouldest keep us steadfast in this faith and worship, and bring us at last to see thee in thy one and eternal glory, O Father, who with thee and the Holy Ghost livest and reignest one God, forever and ever. Thank you. Thanks be to God. Dominus sit in corde tuus in labis tui sit principiandum sanctum verbum Dei per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum. Amen. Thanks be to God. And with thy spirit, glory be to thee, O Lord. Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Thank you. Thank you.
Amen. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father, and he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one holy, catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the church and for the world. Hear our prayer. Hear our prayer. Hear our prayer. Hear our prayer. Thank you. O God, whose never-failing providence ordereth all things both in heaven and on earth, we humbly beseech thee to put away from us all hurtful things and to give us those things which are profitable for us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end. Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you unto everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Deus sit benedictus Dei quis later exhibit sanctus ad aqua, Domine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Sucipe Sancto Trinitas, hanc abationem, carmico indignus peccator affero, in honore tuo beati Mariae et omnium sanctorum tuorum, pro peccatis et defensionibus meis et pro salute vivorum et requi omnium fidelium defunctorum. Nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, acceptam sit omnipotenti Dei, hoc sacrificium novum. Ipso benedicator hoc incensum in quies in requiem abitur, ne patris et filii et spiritus sancti, amen. Dirigatur ad te, Domine, eratio mea, sicut incensum in conspictu tuo. Gloria Patri et Filii et Spiritui Sancto, sicut incensum in... sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Dirigatur ad te, Domine, eratio mea, sicut incensum in conspictu tuo. Corpus, ut personam in clerio per sanctum Domini, per Dominum nostrum, Iesus Christum, filium tuum. Amen. In spiritu humilitatis et in animo contrito, suspiciam Dominiate, sic fiat sacrificium nostrum in conspictu tuo, et te suspiciam hodiet faciabit tibi, Dominus Deus meus. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be acceptable unto the Lord our God. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God, for with thy co-eternal Son and Holy Spirit, thou art one God, one Lord, in Trinity of persons and unity of substance. And we celebrate the one and equal glory of thee, O Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
thank you.
All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by his one oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his Holy Gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here, before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make. Having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we humbly beseech thee, O merciful Lord, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, that we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Da propitius pacem in diebus nostri sut, ope misericordiae tua juti, et a peccato simis semper liberi, et ab omni perturbatione succori periundum Christum Dominum nostrum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia secula seculorum. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Amen.
We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that taketh away the sins of the world.
Body of our Lord Jesus Christ, given for thee. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ given for thee. The blood of our Lord Jesus Christ shed for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Body of our Lord Jesus Christ given for thee. The body of our Lord.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost feed us in these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs to hope of thy everlasting kingdom. And we humbly beseech thee, O heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Please be seated. Very warm welcome to each and every one of you on this wet and rainy Trinity Sunday. I am heartened to see so many of you here. It's wonderful that you all, those of you who are watching, those of you who are here in person, made it through the wind and the rain to be with us all. Now, I promised you coffee hour, but midweek I started hedging and saying, weather permitting. And I would argue that the weather does not permit. So, we will have coffee hour outside on the steps next week, I promise. I think we're going to have to make it a weather permitting thing. But I think that the probability, the numbers, however you want to call it, the odds are going to be with us, and we'll be able to have plenty of fellowship in the weeks to come over the summer. On Thursday this week at 7 p.m., we will celebrate the Feast of Corpus Christi with Solemn Mass and Benediction. That's at 7 p.m., and that's in person and live-streamed. Then on Saturday at 10:30 in the morning, we will celebrate Solemn Mass of the Resurrection for our friend Allison Howard Levy. I hope that you, those of you especially who knew her and knew her well, will join us for that service and be with us here. The service is not going to be live streamed, so I hope that as many of you as possible will join us in person next Saturday at 10:30. It ought to be a lovely service, and it will be a wonderful time for us to gather together and remember Allison and ponder the great mysteries of the resurrection. We're back on Sunday with Solemn Mass as usual at 11 in person and live streamed. I do look forward to greeting you in person out on the church steps in just a few moments. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be upon you this day and remain amongst you always. Deacon Paul, will you chant the dismissal, please? The Lord be with you. Thanks be to God.